Thank you very much. So, Tavi, for all patients with severe aortic stenosis, the answer is obviously no, but still there is maybe almost all patients. So, as you know, the first patient was done now 17 years ago by Professor Alain Cribier. Since when there are 500,000 cases which have been performed in the world in more than 80 countries. What we know is the techniques is very good for non-operable patients, for sure. Is very good for high-risk patients. And there is no more debate about those patients. A little bit more recently, the intermediate risk has been also proven a good candidate for TAVI with those two studies, Partner 2A and Notion. And now that's now what we are doing, all intermediate patients are being performed with TAVI when there is no contraindication to the techniques. So, as you can see here in 2017, the recommendations are in favor of TAVI for those patients, intermediate risk patients, and even a little bit more now with European recommendation, who say when you are with a favorable anatomy for TAVI and over 70 years old, it's much more a TAVI patient. Since 2017, things have continued to move with still simplification as of the procedure, and you can see like this, it was a quite a simple procedure. Now we consider that a simple TAVI case is not as easy as a simple angioplasty, but is probably as easy as a medium angioplasty and much more easy than a difficult CTO. So the patients are coming during the natural program of the cath lab, and there is no dedicated time for TAVI. It's every day TAVI are coming in the cath lab, and we are doing them before or after a coro, before or after an angioplasty. There is no TAVI day or TAVI half day. So PVL is still a matter, but with new generation valve, is it quite effective? So simplified TAVI procedure with local anesthesia, low monitoring, so no invasive monitoring of pressure, of venous access, no TE, preferred TTE, precursing with ProGlide or new device such as the Manta device, use radial secondary access when it's possible, and it's in most of the cases possible, do direct TAVI, so that means no predilatation in except of very calcified aortic stenosis, stimulation on the LV wire, low contrast, and short DAPT post-TAVI. You can see here the length of stay within the hospital is decreasing a lot. And now for those intermediate patients, you can see that the medium length of stay is between 3 and 4 days. Avoid temporary pacemaker because it can lead to pericardial effusion, tamponade, infection, hematoma, transfusion. So you can see that the LV wire stimulation is very effective and very simple to perform. PVL are mostly avoided by a new valve. So the S3 is not a new valve, but we will have the new Edwards valve, which is the ultra very soon. Santera is a very good valve, but I'm not sure that it will come to market because it seems expensive to product, but it was a fully automatic released valve. By you just press a button and you see the valve opening with, it was very, very nice to do Santera, but I'm not sure we'll have this valve available. And also the Evolut Pro is a very nice valve with very few paravalvular leak. Durability, so that's a matter of question. So with the great success of TAVI, surgeon asked us about what is the durability of your valve. And we can ask them, what is the durability of your valve? And I'm not sure they have an answer to that. But we can say that there is a very less mismatch with the use of TAVI compared to surgery. You have, we discussed about that, small, mostly infraclinic thrombosis of TAVI that you can cure by 3 months of anticoagulation. But if you have an elevation, an unsuspected anormal gradient elevation in the months or year following TAVI, you can suspect thrombosis. And you can see here at 5 years, the durability of the valve used in the NOTION trial is very good, much better than the surgeon valves, with a bigger area, a lower gradient. And even in this study, you can see that the durability of the Evolute is very nice. At 5 years, only 4% of degeneration. And you can see also in this study by Hélène Elchaninov that the durability for this multi-center study was also very nice. Bicuspid is still a problem, but we discussed already about that. So, undiagnostic the bicuspid, but the CT generally corrects the thing and say, okay, it's a bicuspid, even if the echo didn't manage to recognize a bicuspid, because it's not so easy with the echo. And you can see the result with, you can see the prevalence of bicuspid, which is much more likely to be found in younger population. So with the arriving of the low risk patient, we'll have much more bicuspid. In this registry also, you can see the prevalence of bicuspid, and the results are with the second generation valve are good, but the procedure is much more tricky. So at the ACC 2019, you know that there is two very big study which change completely things. It was the PARTNER 3 and the core valve low risk studies, and they show that the TAVI was as effective as surgery for everyone. So you can see less mismatch, benefits. This one, okay. So that my point is not to say, okay, now we can TAVI for every aortic stenosis, but we can still continue to move on, to look forward and to say, okay, this technique is really great. And I think the key is the anatomy. And you can see those three anatomy. Imagine it's just exactly the same patient. So the first one here is a standard tricuspid valve. The aortic annulus is very nice, no calcification. Imagine that the size is good for Evolute R, or Evolute Pro valve, or S3. You can predict that the TAVI will be an easy case with a very good result. And I have no problem to do this procedure to a low-risk patient. The second case here, you can see the annulus is, the diameter are good, but there is two small calcification, so it's not a big problem for TAVI, but you can say, okay, maybe I will have a very small paravalvular leak. For sure, I need to use a new device, as the S3 or Evolute Pro, but be careful. And always the same patient, you find this, so a very, very calcified bicuspid valve, a calcified annulus, and you will say, okay, I am sure to have a very good result with this patient, with TAVI. No, I'm not sure of that. So if we are in a high-risk patient, okay, maybe TAVI is a good solution. Maybe I will have a small leak. Maybe it will be okay. Maybe, but still, the risk of stroke is not too low with this anatomy. So if this patient is a low-risk patient, maybe I will call my friend, the surgeon, and say, okay, this patient is maybe a very good candidate for surgery and not a very good candidate for TAVI. So to conclude, I'll just say that 17 after the first case, the TAVI is a very good option for all patients. But that does not mean we need to do all patients. You need to have a standard simplified procedure like PCI, and screening is crucial. You need to do it well and quick with an hospitalization as short as possible. Thank you very much for your attention.